You know what? I'm just going to do what I know how to do best, and that's going to be speak with my videos. All right, I'm done of ranting and raving about this because I've been begging my friends and family members to wake up and smell the coffee and see what the fuck is going on in this country, but apparently nobody's gotten the damn message. So why don't we're all going to sit back and just twiddle our thumbs and watch Barack Obama completely bankrupt our country. And then guess what? We're all going to wake up one morning and we're not going to have bank accounts anymore because all the fucking banks closed and stole your money. And then you're going to blame the bank instead of blaming your own sorry ass for not seeing the signs. Yeah, we're going to end up just like London. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to let my video speak for itself. Go ahead and watch if you feel like it or turn it off like you normally do.
London is burning along with other parts of England, and the United States may want to take note. More than 560 people arrested in London alone after the last three nights of violence. The city's jails are full. When you look at some of these pictures, it's hard to believe this is London. This is one of the great cities in the world, not some third world outback with a ragtag government. Civilized. Looting, fires, rioting, attacks on police. Residents say it's like a war zone. And that there is a carnival atmosphere surrounding these gangs of hooded youth. Make no mistake, it's no coincidence that these riots are happening just as the global economy hangs off the edge of a cliff. Income inequality in England greater than at any time since the 1920s, when this rioting began in one of the poorest parts of London.
You know, I really wish that I could say that I disagree with what's going on in London right now, but from everything that I've watched here on the internet in the course of the last 24, 48 hours, it's no wonder that those people are out there smashing windows out and stealing. Maybe the freaking store owners will take heed to this, huh? Maybe. Maybe they'll decide to stop turning their back and ignoring what their government is doing to the poorer people, because it's not happening to them. It doesn't affect us. Why should we worry? Why should we revolt? Why should we stand up? We shouldn't, right? Status quo is everything. As long as we've got food on our table and money in our banks and our big house and our nice cars and our vacations, Everything's fine. Fuck the poor people. We're not one of them. Yeah, bitch. Well, now they're taking your shit. Maybe you'll decide to do something about it now. And guess what, America? The same thing's gonna happen here.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.